Hello, and welcome to DemBrudders.com on YouTube. This is Roddy Redshirt here, standing in for cartoon characters Dick and Bill Engar, also known as Dem Brudders. If you're not part of IPMS circles, maybe you've never heard of Dem Brudders, but we have a really cool website that focuses on the fun side of scale modeling. Atlantis Models sent Dem Brudders a package with some of their brand new model kits. We're going to give you a quick preview here. We're working on web pages with much more in-depth information about these kits. Check out DemBrudders.com for kit reviews on these and other cool kits from Atlantis Models. At the moment, our reviews for Atlantis Buffalo Bill, Mr. Gasser, and Jolly Green Giant are the number one hit on Google. So check these out and stay tuned for reviews on future Atlantis kits and other cool models. Atlantis Models has been around for about 10 years or so. They have a number of very cool UFO kits that were originally tooled by them, and in later years they've had arrangements with other kit manufacturers for special re-releases of classic model kits, most of which haven't seen the light of day in decades. In 2019, Atlantis purchased a significant portion of the old Revell company's vintage tooling library when Hobbyco went broke, taking Revell USA down with them. Included in this tooling library are classic model kits from Revell, Monogram, Aurora, and others, and Atlantis has been on a tear, releasing fresh versions of these kits every few weeks, it seems. Atlantis Models makes their kits right here in the USA. They're located just down the road from the old location of the original Aurora Model Company in Long Island in New York. They have a newly remodeled website. Check them out at AtlantisModels.com. Their latest kit is this AH-56 Cheyenne. This originally was an Aurora kit released in 1968. At that time, it was anticipated that the Cheyenne helicopter would be put in production and replace the Cobra helicopter, which was based on the famous Huey. Okay, let's take a look inside the kit. What do you get in the box? The really cool thing about their boxes is they've of course got the original Aurora box art on the front. On the sides, there's a ton of information that talks about information about the kit, history of the prototype, the paint colors that you need. On the other side, what's really cool, they have a picture of the decal sheet, so you know what that's gonna look like. And again, some specifications here. They do pack a huge amount of information on the box, and of course, there's a photograph of what the model will look like after it's built. Inside the box, we got the instruction sheet, and they do a really good job with a pretty comprehensive history on the front. And inside, it looks like the old original Aurora art for the instructions. So it's a nice little vintage nod to the original kit. These two big drawings are pretty comprehensive, tell you everything you know you need to know about how to get the kit put together. And of course, there's another photo of the bottom so you can see what the decals are going to look like. Again, on the other side, there's a couple of photos of the model. And using this information, you can really really get the model put together and painted correctly. Let's take a look at the kit parts here. There are a couple major sprue kits here. You've got sponsons, where the landing gear goes. You've got the rigid blades, the pretty intricate the hub rotor and so forth. The fuselage halves, airframe halves, are pretty neat. It shows you what the how thin this was. It was a lot like the Cobra helicopter. We've got the canopy here, which it's actually pretty nicely done. And the you've got the two rotors that make it a compound helicopter that are in here. So a lot of good kit parts. The panel lines are recessed, so if you need to fill seams or whatever, you're not going to lose those lines by sanding down. So that's a really nice perk that came with the original kit. One of the things I like about the kit figures here, they're not identical, so they don't look like the Bobbsey twins when you're done with the model. Another thing, let's see, we've got the decal sheet in here. It looks like the original artwork for the decal sheet. A lot of decals here, so there's some really nice details provided to make a very interesting looking realistic kit. And looks like the instructions have a couple of schemes that you can do. There's a camouflage version, and there's also just an overall olive drab version. And there's the guide for the camouflage version, but I think you can also paint it olive drab all over, have a nice accurate model. Another nice thing that Atlantis does, they've got a card in here inviting you to join the IPMS. Dem Brudders love the IPMS, and of course, we would recommend that you check them out if you haven't already. Anyway, it's a really great kit here that they've done. They've done a great job of bringing this back after many decades not being available, and we're excited to get it built. Check it out. Check out our website, dembrudders.com, because we'll have a comprehensive review with a lot more information than you're getting here. Have fun, and we'll see you there. No, I am not cleaning my workshop. Cleaning is no fun.